beautiful cinematic look of our favorite movies do not come from the cameras that can shoot 8K or 12K. It has nothing to do with resolution. There's a reason that ARRI cameras are now the Hollywood standard for more than one decade and 95% of cinematographers' first choice. It's also the reason that film has always seemed more cinematic than digital. That's the magic of something we call wide dynamic range. Dynamic range describes the ratio between the brightest and the darkest part of an image. The human eye is capable of perceiving around 20 stops of dynamic range. ARRI's latest camera is capable of capturing 17 stops. That's why lots of great movies have been shot on ARRI Alexa Mini in 2.7K, when 8K cameras were around. I was searching for a camera with the highest dynamic range at an affordable price. That was when I found Cinedy's dynamic range ranking. They have tested the dynamic range performances of 100 cameras in their laboratory and made a scientific-based chart. There was no surprise in the top 5 cameras on the list, with ARRI Alexa 35 coming in first with almost 17 stops of dynamic range, Red Zvi Raptor coming next with 15.5 stops, following by ARRI Alexa Classic, ARRI Alexa Mini LF, and Sony Venice 2, each with 15 stops. The interesting results begin with Canon C70 being the next on the list with 14.5 stops. But the next one was a real shock. A camera I was not expecting to see so high on the list. But there it was. Sony's A7 IV was the only mirrorless camera in the top 10. I expected FX3 to be the best one because Sony claimed it has 15 stops of dynamic range, and it does. However, all these 15 stops are not reachable because of the internal noise reduction that can't be turned off. But A7 IV downsamples 7K to 4K, and this is probably the reason for its higher score. But for getting that 14 stops, you have to shoot in XAVCSI 10-bit 422, only 24 frames per second, in S-Log 3 and ISO 800, and also very slightly overexpose the image for getting enough details in the shadows. But if your camera doesn't have a good dynamic range, proper lighting will make it much better. And now great cinematographers like Zach Mulligan, who shot HBO's Outsider, and other wonderful DPs like Joe Simon, have very helpful online classes for it on Skillshare. Skillshare is the ultimate online learning platform for creators that offers a wide range of classes taught by industry experts in areas such as cinematography, photography, graphic design, productivity, and even more. Skillshare created learning paths, which are sequential class collections to master a specific skill, and Ryan Koh has a very good one for video editing. I highly recommend Zach Mulligan's Introduction to Lighting Techniques class as well. If you're interested, click on the link down below and the first 500 people to use my link will get 1 month free trial of Skillshare. The thing I could not find an answer for was if A7 IV has the best quality and dynamic range among all the mirrorless cameras, why it has never been used on anything serious before. We NOFX 3 has been used on Hollywood blockbuster movies before. The biggest catch of A7 IV is its codec options. This may have led cinematographers like Checo Veres to use FX3 as his second camera on Daisy Jones and the Six, and Greg Fraser to shoot Creator entirely on FX3. FX3 is capable of shooting 12-bit RAW externally, and this gives you a lot more depth and information in colors. Also, by shooting into an external recorder, internal noise reduction will not be applied to the footage. And in this way, 15 stops of dynamic range is reachable. Right when I was getting to the conclusion that FX3 with that 12-bit RAW feature is the highest quality camera, I remembered there was another movie called Hannah Grace that was shot entirely on the A7S II, which is an 8-bit camera with barely 11 stops of dynamic range. And yet, somehow they were able to get these amazing shots out of it, that even after 6 years, don't resemble anything shot with a consumer mirrorless camera. At this point, I had to admit to the fact that the more research I did, the more I realized that I'm searching for a totally wrong thing. Widest dynamic range, highest bit rates, 12-bit RAW, all these factors are only responsible for maybe 20% of the look. And the other 80% completely depends on you. Your framing, your lighting, your movement, your crew, your choices. The more you focus on the camera, the less you will be able to focus on the really important matters. I think this is the first time that I truly understand what Peter Adams said 50 years ago. That a camera did not make a great picture any more than a typewriter wrote a great novel.